You don't want to break things. You don't want to go back and say like, oh, Daniel, I'm sorry, I just broke that new truck you bought for 200,000 quid.
I do hear that often, but yes, yeah. Okay, so tell me a little bit about Paltronic 1A. What does it mean? What does it mean for PALFINGER? And what does it mean for an owner-operator? Mm.
Honestly, for you as an owner-operator, you shouldn't be bothered too much with it because it's a computing unit of the crane. And let's pretend the crane's a big computer. Yeah. And over the last decade, we added features like programs. And you know, the more programs you run on computers, I mean, the slower they get. And sooner or later, you come to a point where you cannot run any more programs, but you need to have a faster computer. So the Paltronic 180 is nothing else than a state-of-the-art computing unit. So we can again start to add safety features, like the smart control that you have been using is yes. One of those. It's quite intensive job for the computing unit to do the calculations in regard of safety and so on. Okay. And also like the P-Fold and AOS and all these features that we have, we want to add much, much more because honestly, we're on the way to make a robot rather than a loader crane. This is where we started, but sooner or later, this is going to be a robot and it should work autonomously.
Okay, but this, the Paltronic, are you focusing more on the operations of the crane or health and safety or the control of the crane? What are you?
It is doing everything.
Everything.
Everything okay. Is in there. It has to be safe, so it has to apply to all the safety standards. So that's the basis.
Okay.
And then of course you have, let's say a certain computing power that you use for the standard functions, yeah. The functions you wouldn't see, like for controlling itself.
Okay.
And then the other stuff like that you switch on, that you add, and that gives extra features, offer extra features.
Okay, but with these extra features, within my fleet, we had some of the older cranes as well. And some of the older cranes, they're a lot quicker to use and you have less, less obstacles when you're trying to do it to a job. Would you say you're slowing us? I know you're we're making it a lot safer, yep. But would you say it's slightly slowing the process down with all the new sensors and new safety features?
As an extreme example, if you think about Formula One.
Formula One, yeah.
If you have a skilled driver in Formula One, he's yes. The fastest human being on Earth.
Okay.
But you wouldn't like to get Joe Average to drive a Formula One car.
Okay.
You would rather have Joe Average in a car that has all these sensors, parking sensors, distance sensors,
yes.
and really like giving something that is safe and is making it as safe as possible.
Okay.
So when it comes to cranes, we're always in that conflict that of course it would be easier if you have that top-notch guy yeah. That really knows what he's doing.
Okay.
He would be faster, but the more sensors, systems and stuff you put on,
yes.
To a certain extent, it could end up slowing you down, but it's not the purpose. The purpose is really to make it safer.
I understand. So your angle, okay. So while I may have one man within the company who can dance with the crane, he can lift anything, he knows all the functions, you're saying people who are now coming through, we can make them basically as skilled without less, natural talent.
So and in much shorter time.
A short time period as well, okay.
When you talk about that smart control feature, you know, operating one of these big beauties is, it is tough.
Yes.
And we also tried like to work on simulators and stuff with virtual reality.
Yes.
But the thing is, it is totally different thing if you're in virtual reality and you know whatever I do, nothing happens.
Yes.
So even if it tips over, nothing happens.
Yes.
But if you're standing in front of these and it's like 40, 50 meters of reach, it's an entire different thing.
Yeah.
And no matter how good you are as an expert, you had your first day one day. And that first day is super scary,
yes.
Because you don't want to break things. You don't want to go back and say like, oh, Daniel, I'm sorry, I just broke that new truck you bought for 200,000.
I do hear that often, but yes, yeah. I do hear that often, yeah.
And so this is the perspective. And we all know that it's not getting easier on the one hand side. But on the other hand side, if I come back to the example of cars, like, you know, my first car did not have power steering. My first car did not have automatic gearbox. My yes. First car had a lot, but nothing that was safe and comfortable.
Okay.
And I could drive it, you know, I could still drive it and it would bring me from point A to point B.
Yes.
But today I have a car with an automatic gearbox with all the sensor systems and stuff. Do you really need it? No. Does it help me? Yes. And if I'm driving a long distance and it warns me when I'm losing like track,
yes.
it is something that makes my life better and safer, not necessarily faster.